The public will be very happy with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s first State of the Nation address. That's according to his son, Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos. The younger Marcos says his father's speech will send a signal to investors on the administration's plans for the next 6 years. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno earlier said Marcos would reveal his administration's economic agenda and plans to reduce poverty in Isona as the country faces high inflation and a looming food crisis.
I was with him while he was writing it in the last few days. So I've seen parts of the speech. I haven't seen all of it. I've seen part of him rehearsing it. Yeah, I think people will be very happy with what he has to say. It's going to be on the technical side, but that's what I think people are looking for.
The Marcos administration urged to include resolving issues in health and education in its top priorities. Former Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Ernesto Pernia says these are the main concerns hounding the country at the moment. Pernia adds, President Marcos should seek to empower the full potential of Filipinos by investing in human development programs.
I am more concerned about human development. At least I think that is the primordial, that should be the primordial concern of the government and of Philippine society, because we want our people to be realize their full potential. But we have this crisis, and I think we should address the health and education crisis as well as the food a nutrition crisis. These are the, you know, the most crucial, the most demanding requirements that we should address. These critical issues have not been addressed by previous governments, previous administrations. And for example, if we do something about those in basic education, K-12, in 6 years, many of them will be in college. And even some will be going to graduate school. And so, of course, primary education will be longer distance into the future. But basic education, K-12, is important. Mm-hmm. And at the K-12 level, we should really emphasize the STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So for them to be able to do well in college, mm-hmm, as well as in graduate school.
Members of the business sector lay out their wish list ahead of President Marcos's key address. The British Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines hopes the chief executive will talk about the pending Philippine ratification of the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP. The BCCP believes this will provide a good signal to investors. As for the electronics industry, SAPI says it wants the Marcos administration to review the incentives in the CREATE law and effectively implement the ease of doing business law. It also pushes for measures to reduce the cost of operations. Think tank InfraWatch Philippines awaits specific details of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s infrastructure plans during his first SONA this afternoon. InfraWatch convener Terry Redon says they anticipate more public-private partnerships and multilateral agreements to boost growth.
Even if we shift from overseas development assistance, and then shifting to PPPs. What's most important there is we get the best price for the end users and for the public who will be using all of these public-private partnerships. We should be able to look at multilateral agencies like the ADB World Bank and the IMF, and also the other bilateral partners that we currently have. Most importantly, we've been calling on the new president and the new administration to focus on a social agenda.
Former Senator Franklin Drilon hopes President Marcos will use his political capital to make the hard but necessary decisions in addressing the country's problems. For Drilon, the most pressing issues right now are high food prices and the government's tight fiscal space.
When you have these very tight fiscal situation, you must make sacrifices. And I don't think it is acceptable that you sacrifice the social benefits needed by our poor people. And therefore, you look at the other areas, like the Build, Build, Build program. Agriculture would inevitably involve food security and addressing the very high prices. Unpalatable as it is, on the short term, you must open, he must open his options on the importation of the needed food stuff.
Manila's ambassador to Washington not concerned about moves in the U.S. Congress to strip away aid to the Philippine National Police. American House lawmakers recently passed a measure limiting its security aid due to the PNP's alleged human rights abuses. But Ambassador Jose Manuel Romualdez says it's unlikely to prosper in the U.S. Senate.
From the understanding we have with some of our friends in the U.S. Senate, they will most likely water it down at the least and possibly not pass it. The reason for that is because we have a new administration here in the Philippines, and certainly President Marcos has made it very clear from the very beginning that human rights and all the other issues that we're being thrown our way will be looked into very seriously by his administration. So I think it's incumbent upon the U.S. Congress to let this administration do what it's supposed to do. But then again, just for any reason that they would like to hold any aid to our PNP, as they say, they're not the only game in town. We can get other things that we need from other countries, like what former President Duterte did.
Romualdez also doesn't see the Marcos family's perceived close ties with China affecting the country's relationship with the U.S.
The United States is well aware that we have not only President Marcos has a good relationship with China from way back, but because we have made it clear that whichever country is prepared to work with us as far as our economy is concerned is very much welcome. Mm-hmm. And the United States sees that merely as a, perhaps at worst, a competition. And the United States is prepared to also come in and help coming out with projects that would be feasible for not only for us, but even for them.